we're talking about the importance of Kriya Shema. Right. However, and this is why I think that this mimer is really the source for what Rav Isaac said. The Kriya Shema here is not Kriya Shema in the theory. It's Kriya Shema in the very practical sense. What sense? The mitzvah. You're doing a mitzvah. So, what's going on with this mitzvah? This mitzvah, like I said, this mitzvah, its greatness is that making noise. So the greatness of this mitzvah is that you're pitting your soul against the world. Okay. That's what's really happening. Because he's saying, what does Kriya Shema say? Hashem is one.
Right.
How do you know that?
Hashem said so.
No. You know that a lot more than just because Hashem said so. Hashem, first of all, didn't say so. I don't know where he said so. No, it said, Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad. Who said that?
Torah.
Moshe Rabbeinu said that. Who said that Hashem is Echad?
Yaakov Avinu said it.
Yaakov Avinu said it. No, keep going. So who said it? First one was Avram. He didn't say in this language, but he said Hashem is one. We know that that was his claim to fame, right?
Okay.
That was his purpose in life, to make the world one. So where did Avram get this from? Not so simple. It's not just his seichel. He went beyond his seichel. He went beyond his mind. And he heard an inner call. That's what it means, Shema Yisrael. I think he even says it here. I don't remember if he says it here. He says it somewhere else. Yisrael is the name of every person's soul. That's why the Baal Shem Tov was called Yisrael, because he said, I came with a name. Okay. So every person's soul, in its source, is called Yisrael. So when I say Shema Yisrael, what am I saying? I'm saying to my soul, hey, wake up. What is it you told me once? You told me that God is one. What do I mean by that? What do you mean by that, Mr. Soul, Mr. Israel, inside of me? I mean that everything that I'm seeing as separate and as independent and as autonomous is not that way, really. It's not really that way.
Yesterday.
What? Okay. All of Shari Yichud V'Emunah is built on that. He wants to explain what it means. The Baal Shem Tov's mashal for this was, as he explains, and he starts it off with it in the Shari Yichud V'Emunah, the second part of the Tanya, is the light. It's the Baal Shem Tov's mashal. It wasn't said before him, as far as I know. The light of the sun, when it's in the sun and when it's out of the sun. And we've talked a lot about this over the years. There's a tremendous mashal from it. And if you really want to understand...
Ad infinitum.
Okay. At least he didn't say ad nauseam. Okay. Ad absurdum, yes.
Yeah.
So you tell your soul, but you told me that Hashem is one. So everything I'm looking at here, everything driving me nuts, is really Hashem.
So why are you getting upset by all this stupid politics?
So why are you getting upset? Why are you? You shouldn't. So it's the neshama against the world. Because the world seems one thing, and the neshama says, no, it's not like that. It's not what you see. I'm telling you, it's not what you see. How do you know it's not what I see? Ah, so he says here, because there's two different levels to the world. There's the level of the world that counts. What's the level that counts? The level that counts is what the soul knows, what the soul's experience, that everything is godliness. But then he says, Man she'enken shal kol anivraim, here we're on page 17.
This is exactly what the Rebbe said to Bennett, Netanyahu. He said, you'll be one against 119.
I think the Rebbe said something completely meant something completely different from what people understand. He said, you know your nature. You like to fight. So eventually you're going to fight against 119 people. He doesn't say 119 people are going to fight with him. He's a person who there are people like that. So if you go into politics, it's going to be you against 119, eventually. And it doesn't have to be 119. What he meant was, you're going to fight with everybody eventually. Okay. But the rest of creation is not like the soul. Page 17. Still here, probably.
Okay.
As we say, Baruch Shem Kvod Malchuto Leolam Vaed. So what's it talking about there? The rest of creation is not like the soul. It doesn't have that awareness.
That's what the brothers answered Yaakov. So why is that the rest of the world?
Because they didn't have Yaakov's outlook. They had their outlook. And in their outlook, it's only his Malchus that is over everything. Meaning he has to rule. It's not going to be pretty. Okay? With the soul, it's an inner awareness. I'll say it like this. In the soul, when you have something that has a soul, so it gains an inner awareness at some point that Hashem is everything. And why would I follow my whims? There's no reason to. I want to connect to my source, to Hashem. But the rest of the world doesn't get it.
Is not from the tzivus.
It's from even before. Why is that the question?
Why do you say that he's going to show the tzivus? He's going to
say, again, that's in how it, that's how his But the rest of the world doesn't follow that. So you say, again, this is all related to coming into the land of Israel. So when you come into the land of Israel, what were the spies saying? The spies were saying, you can't conquer this country. What do you mean you can't conquer it? Because all we know is how the soul understands things. And I'm here to tell you, the people who live in this land, you're not going to convince them of what the soul understands.
You're not going to make them from.
You're not going to make them from that way. They're not going to succumb to this. And again, what were they? They were like leftists in a certain sense. They were saying, we want to conquer the land. I mean, we want to inherit the land, but we don't want to do it with a war. How do we want to do it? That everybody will throw flowers at us and rice and welcome us, because you've brought the great truth of reality to the world. That's what a Jew really wants, because that's what the neshama understands, right? The neshama understands this. Hashem is, how could you not follow Torah? You're being stupid. What are you blind? What do you don't understand? I says, yeah, most of the world doesn't get it. Why doesn't the world get it? Because it doesn't have a soul. It doesn't have a part of itself that is from before the contraction. So it doesn't remember. It doesn't see the world this way. Okay? So I may be misinterpreting a little bit. Again, this is based on Reb Isaac, how Reb Isaac understood this mimer. So he's saying, the rest of the world only understands Malchus. So the Goyim, what do they talk about? The kingdom of God. Who talked about the kingdom of God? Said of it. Who in Yiddishkeit talks about it? Letaken olam b'malchut shakai. Who coined that phrase? Yeshua. That's what we say in Val King. Aleinu was written by Moshe Rabbeinu, according to tradition, or at least it reflects the state of mind of Moshe Rabbeinu. Val Ken, Kavel Hashem Ken, Lavir Gilulim in Aaretz, Lim Kaoti Karetun, Letaken Olam Machut Shakai, Vechol Bnei Basar Yikreu, Vishtachavu Lefanecha. What is that talking about? No, that's Yeshua. And that's in conquering the land of Israel.
Yeshua said the first paragraph, and the second paragraph
was
said,
mm-hmm.
No.
No,
immediately before he was executed.
Never heard. The first paragraph is Moshe Rabbeinu, the second paragraph is Yeshua. I don't know where you're going. Moshe Rabbeinu also had a different state of mind. It's not that he only was roses and rice, but that was the main, because you see that he was not violent against the Egyptians. He didn't do anything against them. But he didn't do anything. He didn't come and say, I'm going to smite you, I'm going to destroy you. He didn't. All he said was, beware Hashem, because if you don't let us go, this and this is going to happen. But it wasn't as a threat.
Moshe ran on and said what Hashem told him to say. He was the mouthpiece.
Moshe tried to save the Egyptians if he could. And he couldn't. As far as Moshe Rabbeinu was concerned, the best way to come out of Egypt was, I'm going to go to Pharaoh. I'm going to explain to him why he's wrong. He's going to see the light and the error of his ways, and he's going to send us on our merry way.
That's why he took out the Arab
God. Okay. Moshe Rabbeinu thought the world was neshama, that the world had a soul. And so people would understand. So the spies go in with this type of thinking. But Moshe Rabbeinu himself knows that this is not the right type of thinking for Eretz Yisrael. It's not going to work. What's the type of thinking of Eretz Yisrael? Malchus. Eretz Yisrael is a place of Malchus. You can't conquer Eretz Yisrael with lots of nice words. You can't. It doesn't work. Why? Because Eretz Yisrael is like a microcosm of the rest of the world, where you have to work hard to get things done. You can't, like we talked about the day before yesterday, you can't shovel dirt in Eretz Yisrael. You can't make a hole by taking a shovel and making a hole. It doesn't work here. You have to bring a crane, you know, a tractor with a drill. That's how you make holes here. Because the ground is not hard, it's rocks. It's solid rock. And if you want to do anything here, you're going to have to work really hard. And that's how the rest of the world is. That's what he's saying. The rest of the world don't get this. הגם שאין דבר נפרד חוץ ממנו יתברך כמו שכתוב כי ממך הכל כי הוויה הוא האלוקים שהסתר ואלם שהשם הוקים בכנת שם הוויה וכעדן הקם צריך ממנו מכל מקום אין זה כי אם זיו והרע מתפשט ממנו ואף גם זאת היא הרע מועטת. Still, this thing that dwells within all living creatures, within the rest of the world, is only what we call God's slight illumination. They have some cognizance of the fact that the God exists. But nothing more than that. They don't have the understanding, like our neshama does, that everything should be nullified before Hashem. That's what happens in Kriya Shema. In Kriya Shema, you start with addressing the neshama and saying Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, what the neshama understands, and then you say Baruch Hashem Kvod Malchuto L'Olam Ve'ed. B'kema'amar Hazal, B'yud Nivra Olam, we talked about this. וזהו אשר עשה אלוקים את האדם ישר. פירוש ישר היינו כמו שהוא למעלה, כך הוא למטה. Man was created straight, and straight means the way he is above, so he is below. Here we're talking about the neshama, which is straight. כמו שנדבר במקום אחר, פסוק בדי השם ישרים, פירוש ישרים, שבהם על אדם נשאר שיהיה גילוי אור אינסוף למטה, ממש כמו שהוא למעלה. This is ממש what Rabbi Isaac is explaining.
So how does man go straight?
So how does man, the soul bring Hashem into the world? Mitzvos. That's what it thinks. Gudei Hashem, Yesharim. No, but not just Maise. Mitzvos, specifically.
Maise is mitzvos.
No, bringing a drill on a tractor to make a hole is not a mitzvah. That's the whole point. The hole's not going to dig itself because you ate a Paschal lamb. It doesn't work that way. Again, the Torah mindset is that I'm going to change the world with the Torah. What does that mean? Explanation, elucidation, and performance of mitzvos. And that's going to change the world. And in Kriya Shema, we say it's not that simple. There's an aspect of the world, it's like saying that this aspect of the world is not openly going to change because you do a mitzvah. It's a very interesting thing that he's saying here. He didn't say that. I'm saying what Rabbi Isaac says, he says here. וכמו שכתוב במדרש קהלת, שזהו עניין שכתוב, הן האדם היה כאחד ממנו. ואיתה בראשית רבה פירוש, הן האדם היה כאחד ממנו, רבי יהודה בר סימון אמר, כיחידו של עולם, שאמר, שמע ישראל הוא השם כן, הוא השם אחד, עד כאן ושנו. And man's soul is just like God. It understands God. That's what it's trying to say. What do you mean, I'm like God? I understand that godliness is everything. And everything is battle completely nullified before God's essence.
How is it possible for someone to do the radio?
That's what he said, that there's also another aspect of the world. You're asking how it's possible for a Jew? Because he ignores it. For a moment, he ignores it. And Adam over Avera.
I understand that, but I'm just saying, it's
because we don't listen to our soul. We talked about how the soul becomes extinguished.
It seems inconceivable that somebody could do that.
Right, and that's what the Zohar says. Nefesh ki techta, tava. A soul when it sins, how can that be? The Zohar yells in Gewalt. How could that possibly be? And what we mean is that in the soul that says Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, which is just like Hashem, it means that the light of Hashem is in it just like it is above. There's a whole leap. It doesn't come down in stages. The way it is in you is the way it is before Hashem, the soul. ואפילו לא על ידי אלם בשאר השמות, מה שאין כן התאבות העולמות. But the rest of the world is not that way. צבא השמיים, הם נמשכים משם הווה על ידי השתלשלות ואלמים רבים. But the rest of the world comes down in השתלשלות. Again, how would we say this in the language of Chassidus, that the Alter Rebbe develops later? The rest of the world is השתלשלות. Everything is evolutionary. It comes down stage by stage until it becomes dimmer and dimmer in the light of God that's in it. But the soul is islapshus. The soul is enclosement.
The neshama is exactly the same as it was in before it came
right,
out.
Right, right. There's no change. Right. But the rest of the world isn't that way. The rest of the world is not an enclosement. It's an evolution.
But there are different levels of neshamas.
Seder, again, it's that again. We said in the faculties. In what type of faculties it takes. There's a neshama that works in the tzilus. There's a neshama that was first enclosed in the tzilus and then came down. There's a neshama that skipped down to Bria. So it didn't visit the tzilus. It doesn't have those faculties. Okay. ויש לומר שזהו פירוש ישראל, ישר אל. And that's why the neshama is called Israel. Because it's Yashar El, it's straight with Hashem. Straight means came straight down. No dimming of light, no dimming of understanding. It understands exactly what this world is about. It sees godliness in everything. He just gives more and more examples of it. And then in Idra Rabba, where does it say this? It says, it's called Atik. And Atik is like saying it's before the Tzimtzum. That's really what he wants to say. The rest of the world is not from Atik Yomin. The rest of the world, he'll say, is from Zah. Okay? But the Neshama is like Keter. Keter in the sense that the Keters skip. We talked about this, I think, about the looking up. Then when it comes to Keters, the crowns, you see floor after floor like transparent. It's all transparent. Glass. No, beautiful, clean. You don't, but there's no furniture even. You see all the way up, right? But that's what it means to have islapshus. That's what it means to have enclosement.
ואין מה שנבר במקום אחד ברוש מקומך ובעלים השם על פי מאמר הזוהר חלק ג' דקה אל שם הוויה נגד שער שמות שמבחינת ממלא כל מין.
But the rest of the names, which are not הוויה, they're ממלא. ממלא means it's integrated. This is 100% the source of Rabbi Isaac. There's no question in the world now. I have no question now. He quotes from this. Even the Idra he quotes. The Idra that you just mentioned, he quotes it. So the difference is, the Neshama is Sovev, and the rest of the world is Memale. Meaning that the Neshama is not fully integrated into the world. That's why it remains the way it is. That's why it remains pristine. Because it doesn't fully enclose within what there is. It remains the way it was, as it was sitting before him. What? There is a mamala also, because it has to enclose fully at other stages. But again, that's only in terms, you could say the same thing about our bodies. Okay. Why is it? I mean, you sort of gave this before. Why is it that after you finish learning, you're not a changed person? Why doesn't your skin glow? It should glow. Why is it not glowing? It's because the rest of the world is ishtalshulus. And as much as the neshama now worked inside your body, the rest of the world, again, this is like going into Eretz Yisrael, like what the spy said. Even if you come in, and you explain, and from now until the end of time, they're not going to succumb. They're not going to submit themselves. Why? Because they don't get it. They don't get it the way you do. And you have to accept that. That the world is coarse. Why is it coarse? Because it came down in a different way. This is a tremendous explanation. Right? Beginning to understand why the spies were the way they were. Because they were in the mindset that all we have available is Torah and mitzvot. That's what everybody says, right? That they didn't want Eretz Yisrael because they actually had to work there. What do you mean you actually had to work? What do you mean by those words? What I mean is that it's not going to change just by Torah and mitzvot by themselves. It needs something more. And in the same way that my body doesn't change just because I sit down and learn. And the person hears, Achash begufo yasok v'torah. So if I have any kind of ailment, I should sit down and learn Torah. So he sits down and he learns for an hour and he says, how come I'm not healthy? What happened?
And you do get better when you learn Torah.
That's you saying against Big Pharma? What are you talking about? You live in a different world than I live in. Okay.
The Chofetz Chaim said you never learned a halacha ever. You didn't incorporate it into your daily life.
It's something else.
So he did.
Now the incorporation, that's already what we need to talk about. But even to say that what did he mean? I heard yesterday while I was sitting in traffic for forever, waiting for this accident to clear up. So I heard a shiur from Rav Yitzchak from 30 years ago, explaining this mimer. Actually, it was explained the Chana Ariel, the Reb Isaac's mimer. So he gave something. He said there was something you could see. There was a backdrop from his days at YU. He went to YU for 2 years, he went to the graduate school. And he used to listen to Rav Soloveitchik. He used to go into Rav Soloveitchik's shiur. So he says there's something amazing. He says that the Rav Soloveitchik felt that the epitome of his work, the epitome of his Yiddishkeit, was his book Isha Halacha, The Man of Halacha. What does he say there? That everything is halacha. He says there's even, it almost becomes, he didn't say this. He was very careful not to say anything derogatory because I don't think he feels anything derogatory. He just says, the limit is to the point where itzumo shel yom mechaper, the fact that Yom Kippur atones for all your sins, he says, that is what he feels when he sees the sun setting on Yom Kippur. Not that his sins have been atoned, but the sugya of what does it mean itzumo shel yom mechaper. There's a whole sugya in Yuma, at the end of Yuma, about what does it mean, how much do you need to fast, or what does it mean itzumo shel yom. So the sugya there, in the end, the maskana is that you need to fast. If you didn't fast, itzumo shel yom doesn't work. So he says, that's what I think about when I see the sun setting on Yom Kippur. Is that what you think about when you see the sun setting? What does a normal person feel? I'm 100 pounds lighter. I'm 1,000 kilograms lighter. Hashem just took everything off of me. And what you think about is now the sugya and yuma. Relish the moment. For a second, what Hashem just did for you. Feel what He just did for you. If you're living in the mindset of the miraglim, of the spies, that's exactly the type of mindset they had. You're going to come into Eretz Yisrael and you're going to discuss sugyos. And discussing the sugyos in the Beis Midrash is going to make everybody here bow down to Hashem and accept godliness. That's the mindset.
In theory, that's right. In theory, that's what should
and
be.
And in practice?
In theory, you should bring so
and in practice? Again, and in practice, it doesn't work.
The people couldn't, you know, bear it, and so they would.
In practice, it doesn't work. What he's trying to say is, it doesn't work not because your theory is not right in the world of Atzilus. In the world of Atzilus, you're 100% right. But this is the rest of the world. which wasn't created in the same way, which was not created in the same way.
The rest of the world, which wasn't from, came running to the river to get a dollar from the river.
For what? For what? To know Hashem? They came for health.
But they understood that, that this man.
Did it change them? His did they listen to the Sikha? They had a soul. Some of them did. How many goyim came to him and said, "Ah, we've seen the light. Please, Jewish people, just sit and learn Torah in the land of Israel." How many said that? How many say that today? Trump. Did Trump say, "I'm giving you the Golan Heights because I want you to build a big yeshiva in my name and you'll all sit down there and learn in my name and my merit"?
No.
I can't even understand that. So, seder, somebody could say, it's going to take another 100, 200 years. The Alter Rebbe is saying it's a categorical mistake. The rest of the world is not going to change the way you think it is. And the spies made that categorical mistake. They also made the same mistake. They didn't understand this discrepancy between the world of the wilderness and the world of Eretz Yisrael. But let's see what he said. על כל פנים מובן מזה העניין, והכוח הנמשך מתגלה משם הווי, הוא למעלה מעלה מבחינת הכוח הנמשך משאר השמות. What the neshama experiences, the power of the name Havaya, the direct connection to Hashem, is completely different than what everything else experiences through the other names of Hashem. והיה מה שנדבר על פסוק, ואתה יגדל לכוח עדני. Why did, after the sin of the spies, what does Moshe Rabbeinu say? ואתה יגדל, now may the power of Hashem be increased. But he doesn't use the name Havaya. He doesn't say, may the power of Havaya be increased. He says, may the power of Adni, Aleph Dalet Nun Yod, the name of Malchus. Okay? ומה שנדבר בפירוש, העונה יהיה שמירה ומבורך בכל כוחו, זה פירוש כוחו הוא עניין גילוי האלם. ואם כן פירוש הווי אלוקינו, אנשי הכוח והאור של הנשמות, שזהו פירוש אלוקינו, הוא נמשך מעצמות של הוויה ממש, הוא עצמו מקור וכוח וחיות של נשמה. But here he says, Adni. So he says, it's now, when you say, Yesh Mei Rabba Mevorach, you're saying in the name of the Neshama, the soul. But Moshe Rabbeinu doesn't say that. He says, V'ata Yigdan Lakoach Adni. It's the same Yesh Mei Rabba, but which name are you referring to? If it's the Neshama, it's referring to Avaya. If it's the rest of creation, like what Moshe Rabbeinu now says as a rectification to the sin of the spies, it's Yigdan Lakoach Adni. It's the name of Malchus has to be strong. Because the name of Malchus is something else. Now we need to switch to the new page, but I told you that they changed the numbering a little. So, we're here.
You want 18? I don't have any.
19 here.
Okay.
Here. Okay.
ויהן
מה שאוניברסל דיבור המתחיל וידבר והראה לאברהם בפירוש ולתם כי אני הוויה והייתי לכם לאלוקים פירוש שבחינת הוויה לבדו הוא בעצמו יהיה לכם מבחינת אלוקים אשר היה לכם. And Hashem's purpose is to take the name הוויה and make it into אלוקים. Now we understand better why in Shema we say Hashem אלוקינו Hashem אחד. Because we want to make what the Neshama understands be what can be enclosed in the world, what can be integrated into the world, and that can only be done through the name Elohim. It can't be done through the name Avaya. That Avaya itself be what inspires you, what becomes the Hashra on you. ועדר זה יש לפרש מה שכתוב במדרש רבה, פרשת ותחנן, פסוק אשר לא אלוקים קרובים אליו. And that's what, okay, there's a lot of explanations now. Okay, so what does it mean? How do you do this? Mizeh umeh shekatuv, okay, the next paragraph. Ki karov elecha hadavar. Remember, the Tanya starts with this. Nasbir echu karov. This thing is very close to you. Meaning, Moshe Rabbeinu says about the Torah, it's all very close to you. Perush hadavar, but davar is something else. It's not the Torah. הוא המלכות, כמו שכתוב, מאשר דבר מלך.
והוא עניין שם אלוקים, והוא בחינת קרוב אליך, כמו שכתוב אשר לא אלוקים קרובים אליו. So when Moshe Rabbeinu says this thing is very close to you, he's not talking about the Torah. He's talking about not Havaya. He's talking about Malchus. אלוקים. ובמדרש רב, הסוף פרשן ניצבים, פסוק כי קרוב אליך הדבר מאוד. אמר להן הקדוש ברוך הוא בניי, אם יהיו דברי תורה קרובים לכם, אף אני קורא אתכם קרובים, שכתיב לבני ישראל קרובו הללויה. He says, Torah has to become close. To become close, it can't remain Torah. It has to become Elohim. It has to come through another name. Something has to happen to it. And so he says in the Medrash, when will I call you close to me? When the Torah is close to you. והעניין, יש לבר, מה שנדבר בדיבור מתחיל כי תשמע בכל, בעניין שהתורה נקראת מפתחות הפנימיות. שעל ידי התורה נמשך גילוי בחינת פנימיות, היינו גילוי אור אינסוף ברוך הוא ממש. So the way to understand all of this, what does it mean that the Torah has become Malchus? Where are we going with this? So it says to begin to understand this topic, we have to understand the Torah was called the keys of the inner chamber, the inner keys. What do they open? They open access to Hashem as infinite, as beyond the world.
The Torah?
ועוד על פי מה שנדבר בדיבור המתחיל להיות נתיב בחגבי שלהמשיך ההמשכה במבחינת שורש הנשמה שבה נאמר הווה אלוקינו ממש להמשיך משם האור מלמעלה למטה מבחינת הנשמה שבגוף זהו על ידי התורה אם כן לשיעור עם קרוב ממש או על ידי מיוד ודברי תורה קרובים לכם So how the neshama is above to the way it's revealed inside the body depends on Torah You need to have Torah for that to happen In other words You can't rely just on the fact that the neshama is above as it is below. Something has to connect these two, meaning even between the floors of our building, even though the floors are transparent, but still you want what was up there to show up down here. It says, what does that is the Torah. The Torah transfers it. וזהו שמה ישראל, that's what שמה ישראל means. פירוש שמה משון הסיפה, כמו וישמה שאול. והעניין לאסוף ולקבץ כל הכוחות ורצונות שביסוד האש הטבעי על ידי הכירת הרצון מהם, והיינו להתחרט על העבר ולקבל עליו לאבא שלא ישוב עוד לכסלם, והיינו מפני שהוא בחינת ישראל. Anyway, the point is, that's what we talked about when we said that we're increasing the keter, the fire of the divine soul. That's Torah. Torah increases the fire, the natural fire of the divine soul. Now we're coming to Gimel where the main switch is going to happen. Now he's going to switch. No, we have to finish a little bit more. Just to hear the... Yeah. I don't know how much we want. There's still another page after this. אך אומנם עניין זו מדרגה זו להגביר יסוד האש אלוקי שבנפשו להלהיב לו דפקה בו אין זו עבודה תמה ותמידית. But this is not constant. It's not called finished work. You can't say that the fact that my soul is now enlightened with Torah, and therefore it's connected to its source, and I understand the godliness in the world, and so on. You can't say that that's the finished work. It's not avodat tamah. Avodat tamah means avodah she'en acharei avodah. You don't do another thing after it. You're finished. And it's not constant. וכמו שכתוב לא טוב רע לשבת יצרה. In the same way that it says that the world was not created to be tohu. Tohu is the keter. Tohu is a lot of times the keter. It was meant to be inhabited. That's why, and here he begins to give us the answer of why it's called Eretz Moshvoteichem. Why the Nesachim are Eretz Moshvoteichem. Why? להתראות, שיהיה לך בהצלחה. אתה צריך כסף? רגע, לאיפה אתה נוסע? Can you take him? Where are you going? He can't walk now because he burnt his feet. But he needs to go to the yeshiva.
Where is
it? יד בנימין. Anyway. ועל זה אמרו הקורא קריאת שמע בלא תפילין, כאילו הקריב קורבן בלי נסחים. This is what they mean, that even though קריאת שמע does all these things, this is only for the soul. Kriya Shema is for the soul. And if you don't put tefillin on when you're reading Kriya Shema, there's something missing for the world. What is tefillin for? Tefillin is so that who sees you? V'ra'u amei ha'aretz v'yaru mipanecha. I'm not quoting it exactly correctly. That when the inhabitants of the world see you wearing tefillin, then they fear you. What do you mean they fear you? Because it ain't going to work just by talking nicely. They have to fear God. Something has to happen that they understand in their language. V'inyan ha'tfilin derech klal, uklal kol ha'torah v'ha'mitzvot v'ha'masiyot, ki ukshah kol ha'torah l'tfilin. Tefillin in general represents the entire Torah, but it's an action that you do. כמו שבתפילים מלובשים מוכין עלונים שבעשר ספירות עליונות בתמונות אותיות גשמיות. והוא כצריך האדם להשפיל עצמו לומר די לעבד להיות קרבל ולעשות מכון לשבטו להיות לו דירה בתחתונים. So you have to build vessels. The tefillin is a vessel for everything you just talked about. So what the neshama understood is beautiful. But if there's no vessel in the end, meaning if you're only going to sit down and say Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad. In Reb Isaac's Maimer, he says that the Alter Rebbe quoted another Gemara, which is very close to the Gemara he's quoting now. It's right next to it, I think. It's on the same page. He says, I forgot the Gemara that he quotes. Very similar. He says, Kol HaKore קריאת שמע בעונתה בתפילין, מעלה עליו הכתוב. No, I have to see it. I forgot what the Gemara is. So now he says, tefillin, the reason you need the tefillin, the reason he brings nesachim, is because they all have to do with the same thing. You're going to take this light that you gained when you say Shema Yisrael. But again, you had to cover your eyes because it's a neshama against the world. The world doesn't get it. So you can't look at the world and say Shema Yisrael. You can't learn Torah outside in nature, because nature doesn't like it. You build a building and you learn inside. It's not that you can't, but again, the Neshama doesn't. That's not the way people do it. Because you need another dimension. And that other dimension is the tefillin, is the nesachim. And what they do, we'll see tomorrow.
Bezrat Hashem. 8 o'clock.
Bezrat Hashem.
Friday?